Shalom to the 12 tribes of Israel from the Israelite school of UPK. We are here to teach this subject. Today's subject is going to be about Hebrew, the Lashawan Kodash, which is translated to be the holy tongue in the Hebrew. It's pronounced Lashawan Kodash, the Hebrew language. And we are here to teach the 12 tribes of Israel, who are the Negroes, West Indians, Hispanics, Latinos, the Haitians, all those of Negroid and Indian descent in the North, Central, and South Americas. We're here today. Today's subject again is going into the Hebrew. The Hebrew is the ancient language of all mankind, of all nations of the earth. The Hebrew is the father of all languages of the earth. In the beginning, the only language spoken by mankind was Hebrew. And give me Genesis 11 and 1, just to prove that.
Genesis 11 verse 1. And the whole earth was of one language and of one speech.
See, there you go. The whole entire earth, every nation on the earth, every peoples on the earth spoke one language. That language was Hebrew, and we're going to prove it. It was of one language and of one speech. Read on.
And it came to pass.
That's it. Go down to the sixth verse, because what we're going to read now, during the time of the Tower of Babel, the Most High confounded the languages on the earth because mankind pissed him off because we came together in that one language and that one speech, and we came together to conspire against the Most High. All the nations of the earth went to build a tower to reach up to the Most High and to challenge the Most High. Read the sixth verse.
Genesis 11, verse 6. And the Lord said, behold, the people is one.
It said, the people is one. One world order, damn it, just like the so-called white man is trying to do now. Get the whole earth in one order, one language, one monetary system, one everything, one religion, one worship, one form of everything on this earth. It's the same thing that went on at the Tower of Babel. Read.
And they have all one language.
Go ahead.
And this they begin to do. And now nothing will be restrained from them which they have imagined to do.
And everybody on the earth came together, and the Lord said that if he let them come together, then they will come together and nothing will be refrained from them. They'll come together to try to reach the Lord, go into space and try to be in where the Most High dwells. Like the Lord created a barrier on this earth. We know that is the ozone layer, that the atmosphere. The Lord created a barrier which the nations try to surpass that and go past the Lord's natural barrier of this earth. And they tried to do that at the Tower of Babel. And the Lord got angry and said, this people, they're going to come together and do whatever that's in their heart to do. Read.
Genesis 11, verse 7. Go to, let us go down, and there confound their language.
And the Lord, the angels of the Lord, the powers in heaven, said, let us go down and confound their languages. They was following the order from the Most High, Yahweh. They were ordered to go down and confound the languages of the earth. Read.
That they may not understand one another's speech.
So that they couldn't understand each other's speech, and they, therefore they couldn't come together to build this tower to challenge the Lord. Read.
So the Lord scattered them abroad from thence upon the face of all the earth.
Go ahead.
And they left off to build a city. Therefore is the name of it called Babel, because the Lord did there confound the language of all the earth.
And that's why it's called Babel. To babble is to utter things that's not understood. And when the Lord divided these nations and divided their languages and confounded their languages, they couldn't understand each other. They were babbling to one another. Read.
And from thence did the Lord scatter them abroad upon the face of all the earth.
Go ahead.
These are the generations of Shem.
That's it. That was 10. Now we're going to read further, because the Lord had a brother named Selah who lived during the Tower of Babel. And he had a son named Eber. Eber means pass. Eber lived during the time of the Tower of Babel also. His name means pass. That's where we get the term Hebrew from. Hebrew in Hebrew. The word Hebrew in Hebrew is Ibar. And Eber means Ibar. This brother, he kept the language. The Lord kept that line. Selah was one of the grandsons of Noah, who kept the language all the way from Adam. Selah had a son named Eber. His father Selah named him Eber because he kept the past language. And Eber had a son named Peleg. In the Hebrew is Pelah, which means division. And we want to read why. Genesis 10, Hans, and 24.
Genesis 10, verse 24. And Arphaxad begat Selah, and Selah begat Eber.
Again, Selah had Eber. Read.
And Eber were born two sons.
And two sons were born to Eber. Eber means past. Once again, read.
The name of one was Peleg, For in his days was the earth divided.
Because in his days, the Lord divided the language in those days. So he kept the, Eber kept the Hebrew language, because Hebrew means Ibar. He kept it from Selah. And then his son Peleg, he kept the Hebrew also. But in his name, Peleg means division. Why? Because the Lord divided the nations and divided the language at the Tower of Babel. Read, is that the end of 25? Go ahead.
And his brother's name was Joktan.
And he doesn't go, he goes more into the direct lineage of Eber and then Peleg all the way down to Abraham. And in the King James Version of the Bible, the King James Translation 1611, it also is noted in the beginning of the Bible that the Bible was translated out of the original tongue. Can you read that real quick, guys?
Come on.
In the beginning of almost every King James Translation Bible, it says this.
Authorized King James Version, translated out of the original tongues.
Out of the original tongues. Go ahead.
And with the former translations diligently compared and revised.
Because the original Bible was written in Hebrew.
That's right.
Hebrew was the original language of the earth until the Lord divided the languages.
That's
and,
right.
And the Torah, the Tanakh, all of it was originally in Hebrew. In Hebrew. They even found, and in most of the popular records on the earth was from Ptolemy. And they even found an even older record of the Hebrew in the Qumran caves. An even older record than the records that they got from Ptolemy, and the Hebrew was the original language.
That's right.
Go to so I can go to Genesis 14 and 3, Hives. The Hebrew language, we call it the Lashon Kodesh because it's the holy tongue, the language that comes straight from the Most High Yahweh out of heaven. It's the language spoken by the powers in heaven. Hebrew is spoken by the powers of heaven. All the holy priests, all the prophets, they spoke Hebrew. Our father Abraham, which is the famous patriarch of the Bible, who stood with the Lord and was willing to kill his son because the Most High asked him to show his dedication for the Lord. Abraham was going to sacrifice his son. And Abraham, that covenant that God made with Abraham because he loved Abraham, because Abraham loved God, the Most High, is the only reason why the Lord sent Jesus Christ to help Israel out and to redeem us and to shed his blood to give us a second shot. That covenant with Abraham is very important. And the Lord made this covenant with Abraham and then his son Isaac and then his son Jacob. But let's see, because I hear a lot of talk on the streets that Abraham was a Muslim. I hear a lot of these bearded brothers think they are Muslim and Muslimas, right. Women with the ninja suits, everybody claiming Abraham, thinking Abraham was part of their religion. But we're going to see what God said Abraham was.
That's right.
Genesis 14 and 3.
Genesis 14, verse 13 or 3?
14 chapter and the 13th verse.
Okay. Genesis 14, verse 13. And there came one that had escaped and told Abram the Hebrew.
Abram the what?
The Hebrew.
Abram the what?
The Hebrew.
Go ahead.
For he dwelt in the plain of Mamre.
Right. Go ahead.
The Amorites.
And now it said Abram the Hebrew. Going into some of what Abraham dealt with when he walked this earth, it called him the Hebrew. Why? Because he was a grandson of Eber. He was one of the grandsons of Eber. That's why he was called the Hebrew, the Ibariah. The Ibariah. Ibariah is the Hebrew language. Ibariah is a Hebrew person. Ibar is Hebrew, plain and simple. It's Eber. Eber is Ibar in Hebrew. I know it sounds funny, but Eber is Ibar in Hebrew. Now, go to Acts 26 for me, Hives. Because we just showed that Abraham was a Hebrew, and no, he wasn't a Muslim. He was a Hebrew Israelite. He was He was a grandson of Selah. He was one of the grandsons of Eber. He was one of the grandsons of Peleg. You trace that lineage in Genesis, it take you all the way down to Terah, who had a son named Abraham, and they were all Hebrews. From Isaac, then to Jacob. Jacob had 12 sons, which are the 12 tribes of the nation of Israel. To be an Israelite is not a fraternity. It's not a club you join. You have to be born an Israelite. You have to be a descendant of one of those 12 sons of Jacob. And our original language is Hebrew. We kept it all the way from Adam. Now we're going to read where Jesus Christ himself, Yahweh Shal Mashiach, spoke Hebrew.
That's right.
Read.
Where we at?
Acts 26 chapter and the 12th verse. We're going to read down to 14.
Acts 26, verse 12. Whereupon, as I went to Damascus with authority and commission from the chief priests.
Go ahead.
At midday, O king, I saw in the way a light from heaven.
This is Paul explaining his journey from or to Damascus. Would it read it again, Hans?
Whereupon, as I went to Damascus with authority and commission from the chief priests.
So he was going to Damascus. Read what happened.
At midday, O king, I saw in the way a light from heaven, above the brightness of the sun, shining round about me and them which journeyed with me. And when we were all fallen to the earth, I heard a voice speaking unto me and saying in the Hebrew tongue.
And saying what?
In the Hebrew tongue.
This voice he heard out of the heavens when this light shone upon him and the men around him spoke to him in Hebrew.
That's right.
The heavenly language, man, the language of the Most High and all the heavenly powers. He heard in the Hebrew tongue what?
Saul, Saul, why persecutest thou me? It is hard for thee to kick against the pricks.
Like Paul used to persecute the church. Paul used to persecute the schools of Israel and the people of Israel, working for the white man, like a lot of us do. That's a lot of us join the nations who we being oppressed by and join their government and their offices and be overseers over our people, man. And we enforce their laws and get our own people in trouble. That's what we do a lot of times. And the same thing happened during the time of Paul. Paul used to do the same thing. He used to arrest Israelites and bring them to the authorities to be punished, which was against God. And right now, Christ is stepping to this brother now and saying, why persecutest thou me? It's hard for you to kick against the pricks. He's telling them that you can't win this thing. You coming against my people. After all that I did, you're going to destroy yourself. Read. Who spoke to him? Read.
Verse 15. And I said, who art thou, Lord?
And then Paul wanted to know, well, who are you? Who are you, Lord? Read.
And he said, I am Jesus.
I am who?
Jesus.
With Yahawashah, which we're going to prove later on. I am Yahawashah. I am Jesus, Savior. Read.
Whom thou persecutest.
So now, Jesus Christ spoke Hebrew.
That's
ain't
right.
No doubt. I don't care who come to you talking about Jesus. Jesus was one of the prophets. He was a Muslim too. He was this and that. He was a Christian. Jesus Christ ain't have no religion. He was a Hebrew Israelite, man,
that's
from
right.
the tribe of Judah,
that's
according
right.
to the Bible.
That's
and I know
right.
a lot of Christians, a lot of religions, think they follow Jesus, think they love Jesus, think they serve Jesus. But the scriptures say, he that believeth in me, as the scripture hath said, the same shall, out of his belly shall flow rivers of living water. That's what Christ said out of his own mouth. You can't believe in him according to what make you feel good or how you think you should serve him. You got to believe in him as his Bible said. And the Bible said that he spoke Hebrew. He was an Israelite from the tribe of Judah and had no religion and went against Rome, taught against Rome, taught the men that followed him, taught them to go against Rome. It wasn't at peace with the world.
It
wasn't at peace with the earth. It didn't come to bring peace and harmony. Christ came to plant a seed to take down these nations, man, to take down the evildoers on this earth. Go to, the prophets and everybody in the Bible spoke Hebrew, man. All the Israelites spoke Hebrew. And the Hebrew is such a powerful, get that in the Apocrypha, that prelogue in the Apocrypha above Ecclesiastes. Because the Hebrew is a powerful, powerful language to speak, man. And it's written all over the Bible, man, because the Lord hears us in Hebrew. We're going to get later why it's important to the Lord also. There's 22 letters in the Hebrew alphabet. 22 letters. I know that how many in the English? There's 26 letters in the English alphabet, but the Hebrew, the mother of the languages, there's 22 letters. And the letters are A, Ba, Ga, Da, Ha, Wa, Za, Ha, Ta, Ya, Ka, La, Ma, Na, Sa, I, Pa, Taza, Kwa, Ra, Sha, and Tha. And as you notice, out of those 22 letters, there's only two sounds in the Hebrew language. There's only two vowels, the A and the I. There's only two, those two sounds in the entire Hebrew language.
That's right.
And even if you go to the library and pick up many modern Hebrew books or modern Hebrew subject books, they'll all tell you that originally, all of them say originally, the Hebrew did not have all those vowels that they have today. They admit it themselves. But they took upon those vows. The so-called white man who stole our culture and stole our language and all of our history, he took our Hebrew and tried to devise it and shape it and shift it so that he could understand it and speak it more freely. And that he could separate the words and understand it more. But the Hebrew, when you look at it and really translate it word for word, it's Ebonics. It's Ebonics all over again, just like black people speak. Just like the white man and the rest of the world make fun of black people for speaking Ebonics, Hebrew is spoken the same way. It's real broken up. And so that white people could understand it in their grammar and their proper etiquette in speaking right. They had to add certain things, add vowels, add different ways to do this and that, dots and lines under the Hebrew so that they could understand it, so they could formulate it according to their lives. Read her.
All right, Book of the Apocrypha and Ecclesiastes, the prologue. For the same things uttered in Hebrew and translated into another tongue have not the same force in them. And not only these things.
One more time, I'll start from the beginning.
For the same things uttered in Hebrew.
The same things uttered in Hebrew. Again, the original language of the earth. The language of the Bible before it was translated. Read.
And translated into another tongue.
Go ahead.
Have not the same force in them.
Meaning, once you translate the Bible, like we can pray or say things in other languages, but they don't have the same force as the Hebrew. Again, the Hebrew is a spiritual language coming straight from the Most High, the Holy Father in heaven, Yahweh. And the powers of heaven speak this language. And when we speak outside of that language, it doesn't have the same force. But the Lord also promised that we would speak a bastard tongue. And we would be praying to him in another language. So don't cut your throat because you don't know the Hebrew. We teach the Hebrew at the Israelite School of UPK. We teach it. And the scriptures say rehearse the righteous acts. So we're going to continue to learn it until the Lord put the Holy Spirit back on this earth to let us speak tongues, man. And let us go back to our original language and understand it fluently. So read on, Hans.
And not only these things, but the law itself and the prophets and the rest of the books have no small difference.
Like they don't have no small difference, read.
When they are spoken in their own language.
Like when you speak this Bible, when you speak and say prayers in the Hebrew, is no small difference, man. It ain't a small thing. The Lord don't look at it and say, okay, they trying. The Lord look at it like holy and honorable. Like, look at them. Look at them brothers, man, coming back to me, returning back to my language and speaking the language that I gave Adam. Speaking the language that the angels speak to them in, man. The Lord don't look at it like no small thing. It's a very big thing. And I also hear that a lot of religious groups, even down to the Christians, even down to the old Christian Israelite groups, they don't know the name of God. Everybody act like they uttering the name of God and uttering and saying his name and think they speaking his name when it's important to know the Lord's name. It's important to know the Most High's name, but his name has been trampled in this earth. Like even the Muslims steal from our ancestors, man. The Muslims, they call their God, their idol that they worship, they call him Allah because it's a spin-off of the Hebrew. In the Hebrew, that word Allah would mean God. That's all it means. Not the name of God, but it's a title for God. Alahayim means gods or powers.
That's right.
That's where they get it from. All that As-salamu alaykum, all that is plays off of Hebrew. All of it, man. And they don't know God. His name is not Allah. His name is not Jehovah, which we're going to prove in a second. His name is not Buddha. God has one name. It's not like the Christian church has taught us when we were young that every religion is a different road to the same God. There's many names for God. They all lead to the same God. All of that is a lie, and it's going to get a lot of us killed, man. A lot of us going to feel that fire that the Lord is bringing to this earth. A lot of us. Now I want to go to Exodus 3 and 14, huh?
Come.
Exodus 3 and 14. We're going to show beyond a shadow of a doubt the name of the Almighty God. Because I heard something extremely evil and extremely dishonorable. I heard there's Christian Israelite groups talking about God, the Most High, is not even in the Bible. They go so far as to say that Jesus, the name is Yahweh. That Jesus, that his name isn't Savior. That Jesus doesn't mean Savior. We're going to prove it all to be a lie. And that the Yahweh in the Old Testament is Jesus. The same thing, the whole Immaculate Conception, the whole Trinity, that same thing is being taught by a lot of Christian Israelite groups. A lot of Christian groups are going into this. And even the Jehovah Witnesses are so evil because I talk to a lot of them and a lot of them tell me. I say, when I question the name, why do you think the name of God is Jehovah when the J wasn't even invented before the 1600. You know that's not his true name. And most of them say to me, oh, you talking about the YHWH. They call it that. They call it the YHWH because everybody knows God's name is Yahweh.
Right.
They know it. But it must not be bad to call him whatever, because the world says that whatever name we call him, he still hears us. That's a lie.
That's right.
And we're going to prove it. Read Exodus 3 and 14. Like, the Bible is misunderstood by the entire earth. It's misunderstood. Everything is holy. Everything that the world say is holy is unholy, man.
That's unholy.
And that's the things that they look at to be evil and to be different and to be you overdoing it, that they look at us like we overdo it, because we're serious about finding our heritage and serious about finding our language and serious about serving the Lord as it is written. We're serious about it, and they labeled us the occult. And they labeled us the cultists, the wicked. They labeled us as Satan. But they did the same thing to Jesus Christ. They did the same thing to Yahweh Shah.
That's right.
They did the same thing to the disciples. But we're going to find our language. We're going to uncover the truths, man. Mm-hmm. And the Hebrew is the original language of the blacks and Hispanics, the Latinos, the West Indians, the Haitians, the Panamanians, all the Negroes and Indians of South, Central, and North America. Their original language is the Hebrew.
That's right.
Exodus question, yeah. 1 second, slow.
What verse is it?
We at the Exodus, the 3rd chapter and the 14th verse.
Okay.
Go ahead.
Exodus 3, verse 14. And God said unto Moses, I am that I am.
Slocky, go up above that. Started about 12, I believe.
Connor.
When the Lord first reached 11, Slocky.
Connor. Exodus 3, verse 11. And Moses said unto God, who am I that I should go unto Pharaoh and that I should bring forth the children of Israel out of Egypt?
Jump down to 13. So Moses, he didn't want the job. The Lord came to Moses to tell him to bring Israel out of Egypt and to deliver them. But he didn't want the job for fear's sake. Like a lot of us, the Lord, we see that the Lord got us on a mission, and it's a big mission in our mind. We got to go against the government of America. That's who the Lord sent in the Israelite school at UPK against in these times. In 2007, we to stand on the streets, and we to bring brothers in the truth and speak against the government of the United States of America and every empire that supports him. Those are our orders from Yahweh, Bahashem Yahweh Shah. Those are our orders, and we got to do it, man. And America is a thing called treason in America. It's a thing called treason, but we got to do it anyway.
That's right.
We got to do it anyway. We got to risk our lives. The scriptures say, and we'll get that later, where it say men that have hazarded their lives for the Most High in Christ. Read Hazard 11, 13.
Verse 13. And Moses said unto God, behold, when I come unto the children of Israel, and shall say unto them, the God of your fathers has sent me unto you.
Because check this out. This is something that a lot of people don't know. When Moses said to the Lord, when he sent them on this mission, he said, when I go to Israel and I tell them the God of your fathers have sent you, why didn't he call the Lord by name? Because we're going to read later where the Lord, where Moses, the Israel, didn't even have the name of the Lord at this time. It was Moses who the Lord first revealed his true name to. And we're reading it right now. And we're going to read other scriptures proving that. Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob didn't know the Lord as Yahweh. Didn't know him. All they knew that he was the God. Abraham said, this is my God. Isaac and Jacob said, that's the God of Abraham. After Jacob, all Israel said, that's the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. That's what he was known by. But he's going to reveal to Moses his true name. Read.
The God of your fathers has sent me unto you, and they shall say to me, what is his name?
And Moses knew they was going to ask, what's his name? Well, who is this God that we heard about all this time? We done been slaves in Egypt, and we done heard about this God, the God of our fathers. What is his name? What do we call him? Read.
What shall I say unto them?
Mm-hmm.
And God said unto Moses, I am that I am.
And the Most High got sarcastic with Moses and said, I am that I am. Like the Lord looking at this, like they're going to ask you what? Look, I am that I am. Read.
And he said, thus shalt thou say unto the children of Israel, I am has sent me unto you.
And told Moses, go tell him I am has sent me unto you. That's powerful enough. He the Most High. He the Most High and got Israel questioning him and wanting to know his business. So he said, tell him I am has sent me unto you. Read on.
That's right.
And listen, and I am that I am is not Yahweh.
That's right.
A lot of people made this mistake, but I am that I am does not mean Yahweh. In the Hebrew, it reads Ahaya, Ashar, Ahaya. That's I am that I am. I am is Ahaya. It's a verb like to be, I am. That's what it means. It's not his name. and we're going to prove that that's not his name. Read on.
Christ. Verse 15. And God said moreover unto Moses.
And then he went further to say this to Moses. Like he checked Moses. He was sarcastic with it. Said, I am that I am. Go to Israel and tell them I am have sent me unto you. But then the Lord went on to talk to Moses. Read.
Thus shalt thou say unto the children of Israel.
He said, this is what you're going to say to Israel. Read.
The Lord God of your fathers.
The what?
Lord God of your fathers.
In the Hebrew, that reads Yahweh, which is the Lord. Which is the Lord. That's the interpretation of Yahweh. The Most High, the Creator, the Heavenly Father. His name is the Lord. Yahweh. In the Hebrew, that's his name. He's not a Lord like Jesus Christ, Lord of Lord. He's not a Lord like Sarah called her husband Abraham Lord. He is the Lord. The Most High Lord. The God of who?
Of your fathers.
Mm-hmm.
The God of Abraham,
uh-huh.
The God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob.
Read.
Have sent me unto you.
He said, go to Israel and tell them Yahweh, the power of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, have sent me unto you. Read on.
This is my name forever.
This is what?
My name.
This is what?
My name.
This is my name. Not I am that I am, but the Lord, Yahweh, the power of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. Have sent me unto you. This is my name. Read.
Forever.
How long?
Forever.
How long?
Forever.
Now listen, in the Hebrew it read La Ilum, which means forever. This is my name forever. La Ilum, forever, eternal. Come. That's the Most High's name. That ain't gonna never change.
Come.
Now go to Exodus 6 and 2, huh? The Lord. And it's very important to read the scriptures. Like where the Lord say, this is my name, we gotta pay attention to that. He said, this is my name forever.
Come.
Now we're going to get another one. Exodus 6 chapter and the second verse.
Exodus 6 verse 2.
Slide. Edit. I just want to, can you let me know when I like got a half hour?
Come.
Then 15 minutes.
Come.
Then 5 minutes.
Okay.
The while. Edit. Slide. Go ahead.
Exodus 6 verse 2. And God spake unto Moses and said unto him, I am the Lord.
One more time. Read it again.
And God spake unto Moses and said unto him, I am the Lord.
In the Hebrew, when he said, I am the Lord, it says, I'm Yahweh. The books were written after Moses knew his name. So now in the Hebrew, when they record the records, Anya Yahweh, which Anya is I am Yahweh. I am the Lord. Read.
And I appeared unto Abraham,
mm-hmm.
unto Isaac, and unto Jacob, by the name of God Almighty.
Now, when he appeared unto Abraham, when he appeared unto Isaac, and then when he appeared unto Jacob, he appeared by the name of God Almighty. In the Hebrew, that's Ba'alah Shadia. He appeared to them as God Almighty. They looked at the Most High and said, oh, the God Almighty, and dropped down to their knees, because this was the God that they knew made a covenant with Abraham. But again, read.
But by my name, Jehovah.
By my name what?
Jehovah.
By my name in the English is Jehovah, but Jehovah is the English translation of the word Yahweh. By my in the Hebrew it read, Washamya Yahweh. By my name, Yahweh. Read.
Was I not known to them?
Was I not known unto them? But now he revealing it to Moses, and Israel want to know his name after this time. But by his name Yahweh, Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob didn't even know him by Yahweh. They knew him by God Almighty. Read on. What verse you got out?
Verse 4.
Go to Exodus 20 and 2. Go to Exodus 20 and 2. Because we're going to show further scriptures showing the name of the Most High. And we're going to show that Yahweh is the Most High. And we're going to show that Yahweh is our Father. And we're going to show all of that. They're the same people. So it's insane. I heard about a little prayer. Some Christian Israelites group again. I know I'm on y'all Christian Israelites. We coming at your throat. Because we tired of the lies, man.
That's right.
We tired of the lies. We tired
That's
of Christianity,
right.
Buddhism, Hinduism,
right.
Islam. We tired of Israelites.
That's
group.
Right. That's
we tired
right.
of them all, man. Y'all all going to have to come to where the Lord set Israel up. The Israelite school at UPK, man.
That's right.
And we going to come at you.
That's right.
Exodus 20 and 2. Because the Most High, how you going to say, they say some prayer, our Father in the name of Yahweh? That's insane. Mm-hmm. When our Father is Yahweh.
That's right.
Our Father is Yahweh. And we going to prove it according the scripture.
That's right.
That's the only thing that's going to justify us. That's the only thing that we can stand on is the scrolls, and we want to prove it. Exodus 20 and 2.
Exodus 20 chapter verse 2. I am the Lord thy God, which have brought thee out of the land of Egypt.
And when it said, Lord thy God, it said, Yahweh Alahayaka. Again, Yahweh is the Lord. When it said, the Lord thy God, Yahweh Alahayaka. As we all know in our Hebrew class that we teach, the ka on the end of a word is your. I am the Lord, your God.
That's right.
Your God. Go to Exodus 20 and 5.
That's right.
Verse 5. Thou shalt not bow down thyself to them, nor serve them. For I, the Lord thy God, am a jealous God.
And again, where it said, the Lord thy God, he's saying, I, the Lord thy God, Yahweh Alahayaka. Yahweh, thy power, your power. That's the translation. The Most High's name is Yahweh. And we're going to prove that Yahweh is the Most High. Go to Psalms 83 and 18, huh? We're going to prove it all the way down. We're going to prove the Most High's name beyond a shadow of a doubt. We're going to prove that the Most High is Yahweh. We're going to prove that Yahweh is our Father, is the Heavenly Father. We're going to prove it all. And then we're going to hit you with something else. We're going to disprove the lie that Jesus is Yahweh. Like, it makes no sense to say Jesus is Yahweh when all you got to do is open up a dictionary and see what Jesus means.
Mm-hmm.
All you got to do is look that up, and you know it ain't saying Yahweh in the Hebrew. You know that. So, and you know what I found out? I found out that once you become a religion, once you start following men and turn into a religion, that you can read the Bible and see what it's saying. But what that man's saying or what that woman is saying overrides what you just read in the Bible.
Hmm.
Now, it's an incredible thing to see. We see it on the streets all the time. How Christians say we wrong about what we say. And they say, show it to me. A lot of them smart enough to say, show it to me. And we show it to them and we have them read it out loud on the microphone. But what their pastor just told them Sunday overrides that. They'll read it and say, well, I'm going to still eat me no pork. God ain't going to be mad at me and walk away. And it's incredible to us. Why? Because we didn't learn to follow men that look good, men that speak good, men that sound good. A lot of us follow women that speak and sound good, women that look good, man. We didn't fell as a people, man. But what the Most High always said, Yahweh always say, he reserves several thousand men who have not bowed their knee to Baal. We don't bow our knee at the Israelite school of UPK.
That's right.
We don't do it, man. We ride or die to the end.
That's right, I.
We killed our king.
That's right,
I. Hey, who the hell am I not to serve the Lord till death? They killed my king. I'm ready to die.
That's right.
Biggie Small thought he was ready to die. That nigga was crying, scared, full of bullet holes.
That's right.
Israelite, we ready to die, UPK.
Right.
We ready to die for
That's
the truth. Right. Read it.
Psalm 83, verse 18. That men may know that thou...
Go on. Verse ahead of it, Salaki.
Verse 17?
Come.
Psalm 83, verse 17. Let them be confounded and troubled forever. Yea, let them be put to shame and perish.
This is David praying to the Most High Yahweh against all the wicked nations that come up against him, against all the people that came up against David and his men, man. David had love for the Lord, man. David followed the Most High, and there were still evil men trying to hurt him and do him an injustice. And David prayed for the death. And you read up above, it names all the other nations, from the white man to the Chinese, white man known as Edom, the Chinese known as Moab, the Arabs known as Ishmael. He prayed for death for all these nations, man. And now he's finishing up the prayer. And he said, let them be confounded and troubled forever. Let them be put to shame and perish. Read.
That men may know that thou, whose name alone...
That thou, whose name alone, read...
Is Jehovah.
Is what?
Jehovah.
Now I'm going to read the Hebrew.
That's
it
right.
Said that men may know that thou, whose name alone is Jehovah. In the Hebrew, it reads Kaya, Atha, which is thou, Shamka Yahweh. Thou, your name is Yahweh. That's what it says in the Hebrew. Thou, whose name alone is Yahweh, read.
Art the Most High.
Art what?
The Most High.
So Yahweh is the Most High.
That's right.
Yahweh is the Most High. So how could anybody say, I pray to the Most High in the name of Yahweh, when there's nothing higher than the Most High? He is the Most High.
That's right.
And Yahweh is the Most High.
That's right.
Yahweh is the Most High. You can't pray to the Most High in the name of Yahweh. That's his name.
Right.
Christ said, whoever prayed to the Father in my name, in my name, Jesus Christ is not Yahweh.
That's right.
He's the anointed Savior. He's the right hand, the strength, and the power of the Most High, Yahweh. The scriptures say, Shamkai Yahweh, his name is Yahweh, who is the Most High, read.
Over all the earth.
Over all the earth, man. Over all the earth. Is the Bible a lie? Is the scriptures a lie? Go ahead, Shia.
Question. Does it have to do with anything in the Old Testament, the letters being all capital and lower, some of them lower capitals in the New Testament?
I have no proof on that.
Okay.
I have no proof on that.
Okay.
Slaki. Now we're gonna go to Isaiah 26 and 4.
Okay.
Isaiah 26 and 4 to go further into it.
Okay.
Go further into the name of the Most High. That whole Jehovah thing is crap. The J wasn't invented before the 1600s. It's
That's
a
right.
new letter, brand new letter.
That's right.
So his name cannot be Jehovah, first and foremost.
Mm-hmm.
He cannot be Yahweh.
Mm-hmm.
Go ahead,
Isaiah 26, verse 4. Trust ye in the Lord forever.
Trust ye in who?
In the Lord forever.
Trust ye in the Lord forever. Hebrew translation is by Yahweh, which is in the Lord, which many of our Hebrew students know. By Yahweh is in the Lord. Forever is Ayah Ayah. That's forever and forever. And the direct translation is until eternity. Forever. Forever. By Yahweh, Ayah Ayah. In the Lord forever. Go to Deuteronomy 6 and 4. This is a famous scripture in Israel. And if we still question, you still questioning what the Lord, what the Most High's name is. Hell, we got an ancient credo we say each other.
Right.
In the name of the Most High.
That
was before Yahweh Shah.
That's right.
That was before our King. That was before our Savior. Deuteronomy 6 and 4, you got it?
Cut.
Go ahead.
Deuteronomy 6, verse 4. Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God is one Lord.
Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God is one Lord. Shema Yasha'ala, Yahweh Alahayanawa, Yahweh Akah. Damn near all Israel know that creed up.
That's
and
right.
We still question who this God is.
That's right.
We still question who this is. This is the Most High. For his name is Yahweh, and he is the Most High over all the earth. That's
right.
Yahweh. Now we're going to prove he is the same Most High, the same Yahweh is our Father. So there be no mistakes. He's our Father. We're going to start first at, go to 1 Chronicles 29 and 10. Huh?
Okay.
1 Chronicles 29 and 10. So far we've improved the name of the Lord being Yahweh. We've improved it that Yahweh is the same God that went to Moses to have him deliver Israel. We've improved that that same Yahweh is the same God that went to Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. We've improved that that same Yahweh is the Most High over all the earth, the Most High. So if Yahweh is the Most High, who the hell is higher than him? He's the Most High. He's the Most High.
Right.
But yet you got them simple Christian Israelite groups that claim that you got to pray to the Most High, to the Father, in the name of Yahweh. Like there's somebody higher than Yahweh. That's insane, man.
Right.
That's insane. I got a message for you congregations that teach that mess. Don't drink the Kool-Aid.
Right.
Don't
that's
let
right.
them niggas give you no Kool-Aid.
That's
drink
right.
your own juice.
That's right.
And then come on our class. Read it, huh?
1 Chronicles 29, verse 10. Wherefore David blessed the Lord before all the congregation.
It said David blessed the Lord before all the congregation. Read.
And David said, blessed be thou, Lord God of Israel.
David said, blessed be the Lord. Blessed be thou, Lord God of Israel. In the Hebrew, it said, thou, Lord God of Israel, is Athah Yahweh Alahaya Yasha'ala. Blessed be thou, Lord. Athah is thou, or you. Oh, you. Oh, thou is old Quaker English for you. Blessed be you, Lord. Athah Yahweh, power of Israel, God of Israel. Alahaya Yasha'ala. Read.
Our Father.
Who?
Our Father.
Wait a minute, huh? I thought we got to say our Father in the name of Yahweh, like they're two different people. The scripture, David saying a prayer, said, blessed be you, Yahweh, God of Israel, our Father.
Mm-hmm.
And how long is he going to be there? Read.
Forever and ever.
Forever and ever. Like, it's all over the scriptures. It's all over the Torah. It's all over the Tanakh. It's all over the Bible. Go to Isaiah 63 and 16. It don't make sense, man. The Lord done revealed secrets unto us, man. He done revealed such great gifts to us. giving us our language. Step by step, we learn in our language. We learn to say the name of the Lord. We learn to know who he is, know how to pray to him in our ancient holy language. And a lot of us reject it, man, because we'd rather swing from the testes of a man. We rather swing from the breast, the nipplets of a damn woman, some big woman in the congregation teaching us, man. We'd rather serve men, man. We'd rather serve women than to serve the Lord. What kind of, how can we get some courage, black man?
That's right.
About time we get some courage, man. Stand against the masses when you know it's right. You fearing exile. You fearing being pushed aside. You fear having your backs turned against you. Take it, man. Your king took it.
That's right.
Your king took it. The disciples took it. When people turned their back against him, but they stood for what's right, man. They said, I could give a damn.
That's right.
They said, I could give a damn. Read.
Isaiah 63, verse 16. Doubtless thou art our father. Though Abraham be ignorant of us.
Read it again, 63 and 16.
Doubtless thou art our father.
Go ahead.
Though Abraham be ignorant of us, and Israel acknowledge us not.
So now he's talking about our father. Isaiah praying and saying to some power that you are our father. Doubtless thou art our father. Read.
O Lord, art our father.
O Lord, art our father. Read that again. Though Abraham what?
Though Abraham be ignorant of us, and Israel acknowledge us not.
Right, because the whole nation was falling apart. Go ahead.
Thou, O Lord.
Thou, O Lord, in the Hebrew, it reads, Atha Yahweh. Thou, O Lord, you, O Lord, you, Yahweh, read.
Art our father.
Abba Yahweh. Abba Yahweh in the Hebrew. Atha Yahweh, Abba Yahweh. Thou, O Lord, Yahweh. Art our father, man.
Right.
Yahweh is our father.
That's
man.
Right. That's
so we
right.
can't pray to the Father in the name of Yahweh when he is our father. Yahweh is the Father. Real quick, Isaiah 64 and 8.
Right. Isaiah 64, verse 8. But now, O Lord.
Oh, hold up. But now, O Lord, wa'aitha Yahweh. Again. Wa'aitha Yahweh. But now, O Lord, read.
Thou art our father.
Abayanawa Atha. Abayanawa Atha. Wa Aitha Yahweh Abayanawa Atha. The Most High Yahweh is our father, man. He's our father. Now, before the time run out, I'm going to show you the name of Jesus. The name of Jesus Christ.
That's right.
I ain't mean to sound Christian to that, boys. Forgive me. We're going to go into the name of Jesus Christ. Yahweh Shah Mashiach.
That's right.
His name is Jesus Christ. That's what he's known by because it was written in Greek. The New Testament was a book written in Greek. And so the translators translated it from Greek into English. So they had Greek names like Jesus. Jesus means the same thing as Joshua of the Old Testament. But Joshua was translated from the Hebrew straight to the English. Whereas Jesus was translated from the Greek to the English. Then you had other people, other rulers of this empire took that English from the Greek and translated it back into the Hebrew, which you had some problems with it, some flaws. And I'm going to show you the flaws, then I'm going to show you in them flaws that they put the truth. Why? Because the white man is the devil.
That's right.
First, we're going to prove the name of Jesus Christ. Matthew 1 and 1. And
Matthew
his name
1,
ain't Yahweh. We're going to prove that his name is not Yahweh. Read.
The book of the generation of Jesus Christ.
The book of the generation of Jesus Christ. In the Hebrew, it reads Hamashiach Yahshua. Now, this is the first incorrection translating from Greek to English to Hebrew. That they took the name Jesus, which was from a Greek word, and tried to translate it back into the Hebrew and got the letters misconstrued. And they call it Yahshua, but we know as Yahawasha, and I'm going to prove it further down. Go to Matthew 1 and 21.
Matthew 1, verse 21. And she shall bring forth a son.
Again, the she is talking about Mary. The angel came to Joseph and told him what was going to go down and told him that she was going to bring forth a son. Read.
And thou shalt call his name Jesus.
And the angel told Joseph in this dream that you're going to name him Jesus, which means Savior. In the Hebrew, it's Yahawashah. Read.
For he shall save his people from their sins.
Now go hold that high. I'm going to come back to Matthew 1. Go to Isaiah 9 and 6. We're going to go. Yeah, give me Isaiah 9 and 6, guys.
Isaiah 9 and 6. For unto us a child is born, mm-hmm. unto us a son is given,
right.
and the government shall be upon his shoulder.
Right, because he ruled over Israel. He claimed the seat of David, the throne of David. Read.
And his name shall be called Wonderful.
Because he was.
Counselor.
Uh-huh.
The Mighty God.
The Mighty God, the Mighty Power, because he was a power. Read.
The Everlasting Father.
The Everlasting Father. And a lot of Christian groups get misled by this. Jesus Christ wasn't the Heavenly Father, but he was called the Mighty Father, just like Paul said, I have birthed many. You have had teachers many, but fathers you haven't had many. Because I birthed you all. Paul referred to himself like a father of Israel because he was like the progenitor of Christ's message. He was like one of the forerunners of the message, just like Jesus Christ, Yahushua Mashiach. He's the forerunner of the saving of Israel. Go ahead.
The Prince of Peace.
Mm-hmm.
Of the increase of his government and peace, there shall be no end.
There shall be no end. Go back to Matthew 1 and 21 and hit that. There shall be no end of Christ's reign once he returns.
Matthew 1 verse 21. And she shall bring forth a son, and thou shalt call his name Jesus,
mm-hmm.
for he shall save his people from their sins.
And again, where it says Jesus, they translated from Greek, and it said Yahshua, but we know it to be Yahusha, and I'm going to prove that they know it to be Yahusha. Read on, us.
Verse 22.
Now all this... No, never mind. Go to 20, the last verse, 25.
Verse 25, and knew her not till she had brought forth her firstborn.
So once Joseph laid with her, because the verse above called her his wife, and then it said he knew her not. He didn't have sex with her. Once he got married pregnant, once the Spirit had him get married pregnant, he did not have sex with her again until Yahushua was born. Read.
And he called his name Jesus.
And called his name what?
Jesus.
Yahushua in the Hebrew. And I'm going to prove it. Now go to Acts 7 and 45, where I'm going to show you another brother named Jesus. Another brother named Jesus. In the Old Testament, he wasn't called Jesus because the Greeks wasn't empowered and he was called something else. But in the New Testament, they're going to refer to him as Jesus and it's not talking about Jesus Christ. Read Acts 7 and go to 44.
Acts 7 and 44. Our fathers had the tabernacle of witness in the wilderness as he had appointed, speaking unto Moses, that he should make it according to the fashion that he had seen.
Go ahead.
Which also our fathers that came after brought in with Jesus.
Talking about after Moses brought in with Jesus, but it ain't talking about Jesus Christ. It's going to prove it. Read.
Into the possession of the Gentiles.
Go ahead.
Whom God drave out before the face of our fathers unto the days of David.
Until the days of Joseph, until the days of David. So who's this Jesus he's talking about? When you check it out, it's talking about Joshua. It's talking about Joshua. Joshua held the reins for Israel until the times of King David, until those times came in. It called him Jesus. Why? Because Joshua and Jesus means the same thing. It means Savior. Joshua is the English word for the Hebrew word Yahushua.
Right.
When Jesus is the Greek word for the Hebrew word Yahushua. But translated from Greek into the English, it's read Yahshua, but it's pronounced Yahushua. And Shia, I'll show you that. Go to Luke 2 and 22. Go to Luke 2 and 22, huh?
Luke 2?
Luke 2 and 22.
Luke 2, verse 22.
Speaking about Joseph, remember, it said Yahushua. Go ahead.
Luke 2, verse 22. And when the days of a purification according to the law of Moses were accomplished.
And this is Yahushua. When Jesus Christ was born, when Yahushua Mashiach was born, Mary's days of purification came at an end, her time of rest before the circumcision, the 8 days. Read.
They brought him to Jerusalem to present him to the Lord.
To present him to who?
The Lord.
To present him to who?
The Lord.
And when you look that up, when it said present him to the Lord, it says Yahweh. Mm. It says Yahweh. Even in the New Testament Hebrew, they knew it was talking about Yahweh. Right. So they presenting Yahushua to Yahweh. And his circumcision. They're two different people, man.
That's right.
The Trinity is a damn lie. You Christian Israelites need to be hung.
That's right.
Lie for teaching that lie. Read.
Verse 23. As it is written in the law of the Lord, every male that openeth the womb shall be called holy to the Lord.
So why was he brought before the Lord? Why was he brought to this place before the Lord? Because every male that opened the womb is called holy to the Lord. Mm. And in the Hebrew, it said, Kwadawash, Yaqora'ah, La Yahweh. Mm. La Yahweh. That's why Christ was brought before Yahweh, because every male that openeth his mother's womb is holy to Yahweh. Yes. And so with that, we're going to finish it there. And we're going to finish it there and showing you that the name of the Most High is clear in the scriptures. It is Yahweh, and it means the Lord. Plain and simple. Plain and simple. And Jesus Christ, his name in the Hebrew is Yahawashah HaMashiach, the anointed Savior, or the Savior that's anointed. That's what Jesus Christ means. It's insane to think that Jesus is Yahweh, man. We're going to come back to our culture and find the truth, man. In the Hebrew slop, Yahweh, go to Zephaniah. It's real quick. Zechariah, just to show you why it's important for us to know this Hebrew and know the name of the Lord and know the name of Yahawashah. Zechariah, fast as we can do it. Zechariah, the ninth verse.
What chapter?
Oh, Zechariah, the 13 and 8.
Zechariah 13, verse 8.
Come. Show you more Hebrew. Go ahead.
Zechariah 13, verse 8. And it shall come to pass that in all the land, saith the Lord, two parts therein shall be cut off and die.
So two-thirds out of Israel are going to die because we want to join religions and we don't want to follow this Bible like you said. We want to lie about the name of God and the name of Jesus Christ. Read.
But the third shall be left therein.
But the brothers that stand for the Lord against the masses, because they know it's the truth and know it's right, and stand against the popular society because they evil, they're going to make it through that fire. Read.
And I will bring the third part through the fire.
Go ahead.
And when we find them as silver as we find.
Like, we're going to come out of the crack, the heroin, the gun violence, the poverty, the prostitution, the AIDS, the disease. We're going to come out of all the oppression, the murder. We're going to come out of it, man, because we stood for the Lord. Read.
And we'll try them as gold is tried.
And make us pure. Read.
They shall call on my name.
We're going to call on the Lord's name. And we're going to call on his name, and his name is Yahweh. Read.
And I will hear them.
And he's going to hear us. Go ahead.
I will say, it is my people.
He's going to know we his people. Why? Because we didn't call on his name. We didn't say Yahweh. Bahashem Yahweh Shah. Go ahead.
And they shall say, the Lord is my God.
And we shall say, the Lord is my God. Wahawa'ah, Ya'amar, Yahweh Alahaya. That's what we're going to say. Mm. The Lord is our power, man. And we're going to get, and it's been a beautiful thing to learn our ancient language and learn his Hebrew. Because the Lord going to hear us calling his name. If we call him Steve, he ain't going to answer. If we call him Joe and Bob, he ain't going to answer. We hollering out Allah and Buddha, he going to, who the hell is them simpleton? But we're going to holler the true name of the Lord, Yahweh, man. And we also, other than the ancient Hebrew that we got the Assyrian Hebrew also. Because when Israel went into the Assyrian captivity, 722 B.C., we did the same thing we always do when we're being oppressed. We adopt their ways. We spoke our Hebrew, but we started to take their letters on. And that's how we came up with the Hebrew that you see today, that so-called modern Hebrew in the Torah, through the Assyrian captivities. Some people call it Phoenician Hebrew, this and that Hebrew, but we got it from the Assyrian captivity. And also, we got different symbols. We got the symbolic meanings of the Hebrew letters that Adam, where Adam got the Hebrew letters from. We got that from him also. And we got what the different letters mean. And also that Aramaic garbage. They try to say Yahawashah spoke Aramaic. We read in the scripture where he said spoke to Paul in the Hebrew. Aramaic is some old made up language that come from a guy named Aram. A guy named Aram in the scriptures who did not fall into the line of the covenant people, man. He did not fall into the lineage of the holy people from Abraham, Isaac, Jacob, and the 12 tribes. So he ain't got nothing to do with what's holy. Nothing to do with God, the Most High Christ. Shalom. Here we have the symbolic meanings of the Hebrew, some of the Hebrew letters, 15 Hebrew letters. We have symbolic meanings for them. The reason why Adam chose these letters and these forms and called them what they called them. For instance, you have the Ah, because the cattle in Hebrew, the word for cattle is alap. And so that's where he got the Ah from. And you see the shape of the cattle's head. For instance, the house, Bayaf. You see the shape of the house, you get the letter Ba from. Ga, for Gamal, camel, hump. He get that shape of the letter Ga from the camel's hump. Da, the door, the tent. He get that shape, that he saw that shape on the tent, and that's how he got the letter Da. So forth and so on. They have Wa for the fish hook, which is Wawa in the Hebrew. That's where that shape comes from. The Za comes from, it says weapon, but it's Zion for weapon, because that's the instrument they use for cutting crops and shearing crops.
the yod it get from the hand, the form of your arm and your hand open, which is yod. I mean, that's Hebrew for hand. You got the kop, which is the palm of a hand. Kop, the palm of a hand. Ma is the wave of water. Mayam, which is water in Hebrew. That's where the shape of the ma comes from, the water wave. Sa, which is makah, you get from the antenna, flag support. Samak, you got the eye. Ayun, which is the shape of an eye, the circle shape. The pa is the shape of a mouth, the open mouth, pa. The ra, you get ra'ash, is head, from the shape of a head. The sha is the root of a tooth, which is shan. And the tha is like a sign, thawa in the Hebrew. So this is where Adam's got these 15 letters from, these symbols. So.